Greetings, gang. It's your old pal, Stinky Whistle Cheeks. It's Patrick over at the old Odyssey 2 fans group and Magnabox Odyssey 2 page there on good old Facebook. Hope you guys had a great Memorial Day weekend. I thought I'd end it by sharing a little Shay Maxime gameplay. There's our chef down there serving up food that he obtains out of nowhere over on the right, and then he puts it on the elevator in our three-story mustard-colored restaurant to provide to you, the waiter. You've got to serve the food properly over on the opposite side of the table. If you've ever waited tables, which I was at one of my college gigs, that's the proper way to do it. I think you serve to the right. I don't know, but in this game, you just serve opposite the opposite your patron there. Now you'll notice they're changing from the color green to red, and that means that time is running out and they're getting impatient. When they finally get to their boiling point, they start vibrating, and they make a sound similar to a telephone, thanks to the Intel technology. I think it's what, the 8088 is audio and the 8048 was the video. Don't quote me on that, but I know there's two Intel chips in there, and I believe one's doing audio and one's handling your graphics. Could be wrong there. The stairs work great. They're almost like escalators. They're nice and fast, so they're not frustrating. They only, maybe a little bit of frustration is lining up to get going, but they're pretty easy to use. I like that. I'm trying to think of a game with difficult stairs. Popeye. Popeye stairs can be challenging, depending on which version you're playing. And the controller you use. I want to say the ColecoVision Popeye, which has fantastic graphics, has a very frustrating set of stairs. Odyssey Popeye. We're going to have to take a look at that at some point. We'll check those stairs out. Does the Odyssey Popeye have stairs? I think it does. But we'll check it out. But Shay Maxime's great. I recommend putting on a little jazz fusion. And, or something. But so, you get four guys. There's your three lives up there and the one on screen. You'll lose a life if a guy gets impatient and walks out without getting his food. This must be takeout, because once they get their food, they just beat it. Or they eat really fast. But my little tactic is, and I'm not any kind of, I think my high score is somewhere around 600, is to grab the food at whatever level you're on and take it to where you need to take it. Did you catch that little dog? So he's hilarious. I love his animation. He's got a little black nose and his legs move quite fantastically. A little pixelated dog. Now he'll take your food if you have food in hand. If you don't have food, you can touch him and kick him out of the restaurant. But if you've got food, he wins. He takes you, takes your food and knocks you over and runs off with it, and there's a certain amount of time where you're frozen. Ooh, I was lucky there. He starts speeding up when he sees you with the food. So it's one of those establishments where they let you bring a dog in. Uh-oh, see, I'm gonna get him first. I probably could have just let him walk back out. I might lose a guy over this. Oh, no. Okay, I lost a guy up there. Basically, the icon turns to a forward-facing Odyssey guy, and that means he lost it. Uh-oh. And I got hit by the dog. So it's challenging. It takes practice. It's a busy restaurant. Figuring out your most efficient logistics possible. So So anybody that ever said that playing video games is a waste of time, I would strongly disagree. I think it helps with your mental capacities in very different ways, in all kinds of ways. Even though, you know, the game might not be deemed educational, you learn to deal with a certain amount of tension and stress with a situation, which I think it's kind of challenging with young folks these days. Games were harder back in the day. You know, you play Sonic the Hedgehog or something, and I popped that cartridge in the other day, and I never really enjoyed that game. And I basically didn't enjoy it again because it's just too easy. I think a lot of games that came after the second gen, which were really the first video games, were much easier. Some are fun, but they're just not that hard. You know, you just like roll along and jump and collect coins, and it's really hard to die. Our games, it seems like it was pretty easy to die. I was talking to my buddy Paul McCormick. He has the Atari and Beyond Group page. And he posted an old video of a Space Invaders contest. And I said, you know, to this day, Space Invaders is one of the most difficult games. It's really hard to get a good score on that game. It's simple, but it's challenging. You notice the games that came after Space Invaders, the Space Invader sliding shooter clone games, a lot of fantastic ones, but they were remarkably easier, I think. I think Space Invaders was one of the hardest of that genre, and the first one. But that is a little wrap on that. Uh-oh, my dog is kind of dead. So basically, you lose a life if a guy walks out without food. And the dog will just take your food. I never really saw any type of instructions for the game, but it wasn't too hard to figure out. And I'm closing in on, I think, actually one of my best scores. So, you guys let me know if you've got Shane Maxine. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. Wisdom or high scores. See, once you screw up now, like that guy, 660. Not bad. There's a little Shane Maxine. And my thoughts for the day on stuff and nonsense. This is on the multicarp. And I think there's probably a ROM you can download. But I think it's well worth it. Just for that mustard colored three-story restaurant and the purple sidebars. Anyway, guys. Game on, and remember to select game even though you already have the cartridges in, but it asks you to select the game anyways. Shouldn't it say select level or select game version? I'm just being silly. But that always cracked me up how when you put in an Odyssey 2 cartridge it says select game. It was like I already did. Anyway, we didn't care. It was the 70s, man. Rock on.